Yes. We always love to talk to this gentleman. Probably portrays one of my single favorite characters in television in decades. From Baskets with Zach Galifianakis, Martha Kelly. He plays Christine Baskets so beautifully. Louie Anderson. Louie!
Good morning.
Oh, God, I love you so much.
It's slipping into a warm bath with Louie.
I had so much fun playing Christine Baskets, man.
Well, it actually aligns nicely with what we're talking about because you have said in many interviews with us and in general that you were kind of just channeling your mom, right?
Absolutely. I mean, you know, like I ask people, don't call me Louie on the set, call me Mama Baskets or Christine. And I would always say to the director, hey, do you mind, Jonathan Kreisel, by the way, great director, did Portlandia and many other things. But I say, hey, can I do it how my mom would do it? And he said, yeah, give it a try. And that was the most fun thing. I always tell people, don't give up. I got my best part in television when I was 61 years old. Don't give up on yourself.
It really is amazing with you that if you see it immediately, you're like, okay, this is Louie Anderson, wig, makeup, dress. And then halfway into the very first episode that you see you forget that it's Louie.
Yeah, Louie disappears.
And then you introduce Ken, who owns the carpet company, and you're rooting for those two. You want those two to work out, and I'm looking at you protectively, Christine, Mama Baskets. I'm looking at that guy, Ken. I'm like, if you break her heart, I'll come through this TV. And thank goodness he never did. Thank goodness he didn't do that, because I love that. That
Alex
scene with you two,
he great does, actor.
Great actor. He's amazing. Everybody on that show is great. So, Louie, it's been a minute, man. The world was flipped upside down since the last time we talked to you. People got locked inside. All they were doing was doing cameos and podcasts and weird YouTube videos. What's Louie been up to for the past year?
Well, I have been doing exercise from my pool, which is one of the things that I put on social media that was fun. And then I've been doing cameo. I got Mother's Day cameos coming out. That has been really good because you get to reach your fans. And I really love doing the. It makes me feel good, and it's my way of connecting. You know, it's a really great organization over there, and I have been doing that, and I've been working on a new hour of material that's going to be on my special.
Whoa.
And I love stand-up comedy. It's my 43rd year, probably my 7th or 8th special. But this is such a new venue because, you know, I'm going to be doing it virtually. So it's going to be a whole different thing. So luckily, I talk to myself all the time. So it's going to work out.
Yeah, let me ask. They just recently reopened the Comedy Store in L.A. And everybody's kind of celebrating that. Seems like we're getting back to business. But you're going to be doing this one virtually. Will there be anybody in attendance? Or will it be just you, camera?
I think there might be. Well, there's quite... You know, I think there's going to be some of the VIPs in that are going to be live where I can hear them and that kind of stuff. But I'm going to have a couple special guests who are going to pop on because I'm in Vegas. There's lots of celebrities here. And then there's going to be speaking of Baskets, I can't say who, but there's going to be a special appearance by one of those characters.
Oh, nice.
Yes.
Yeah, so...
We're excited.
It's going to be a lot of fun, you know. And originally we're going to do it on Mother's Day, but we couldn't pull it all together by then. So we did it. It's kind of a tribute to Mother's Day with my book, Hey Mom, and Father's Day, my book, Hey Dad. I mean, Dear Dad. And so I'm really looking forward to it because it's going to be a brand new experience for me. But it's a way for me to connect with everybody, no matter where they live, where they are.
And speaking of stand-up, Louie Anderson, I was watching a documentary about comedy, about a specific comedian. But this comedian talked about the Tonight Show and how back in the day, the 80s into the early 90s, whenever that run was, that getting the call to go on the Tonight Show, that was the thing that put you over, which that doesn't exist. Something so singular like that doesn't exist anymore. What was that like?
No, the making... closest you... Well,
go
I
ahead.
Mean, it was the, you know, it was the most important call you got.
Yeah.
No matter what, as a stand-up in the 80s. And I remember I auditioned for 2 years to get on the Tonight Show.
Wow.
And the guy who booked it really didn't like me. But I knew I'd be good on the Tonight Show. I grew up watching it with my dad. My dad was a musician. He liked Doc Severinsen. And so he'd let me stay up and watch the comedians. I go, I'm going to kill this Tonight Show when I get on there and do it. And I had those jokes so prepared. When I finally got the Tonight Show, I had 9 Tonight Show sets locked and loaded and ready to go for that first, you know, first 9 appearances. And the first one, it was an out-of-body experience for me, and it was just unbelievable.
You know what was a great late-night talk show that I feel like it had its legs taken out under it a little bit too soon? Obviously, you've got your Lettermans, you've got your Carsons. These days, you've got your Conans and stuff. But a guy that was a comedian that loved other comedians, and he only had the show for, I think, 2 or 3 years, was George Lopez's Lopez Tonight. George Lopez he made that a primary feature of his show, that he wanted undiscovered, unheard of, not an open micer, but no one has ever heard of this person talent. He featured so many great comedians on that show. And apparently, compared to what you went through and others go through, you know, you get rejected and rejected, and they want you to change this word, and they want you to change this down and script it all out. He would just trust you. And more often than not, it'd go great. Is that sometimes frustrating, that process? You just want to grab that producer, that director, and go, if you'll trust me, you're going to get a great set.
You know, I think you're right. But George was ahead of his time with his talk show. If George did that, you know, even 5 years later, I think he'd still probably be on, because he's a natural host. He's a lot of fun. Great guy. And so... But, yes, you like having somebody really before you. But I have to say this about those producers who don't like you and who are finicky and are telling you what to do. They drive you.
Make
you better in their own weird way.
Okay.
Because you go, I'm going to kill this set. And you're going to, afterwards, here's what I used to do, and nobody knows this. I would do a joke that we hadn't rehearsed just to get back at them. I would do it live on TV. That night, and you go, hey, I never okayed that joke. And I go, oh, didn't you? I thought you did.
Wow.
Did they? Go ahead.
Every single one, I threw a new joke in there.
Good for you.
And
you still got back on, so.
Johnny liked me. Once Johnny liked me, that guy had no power whatsoever over me.
There you go. The guy actually has the crown on goes, no, it's Louie. He's approved. He's going to do his thing. The book, you got to check it out.
You know, none of those talk show stars knew that the producers were making our lives miserable. And those producers who are making our lives miserable were just trying to save their jobs and not want the comedian to screw up.
And how many of those producers were failed comedians themselves, almost enacting a bit of revenge on the product?
Yeah.
You know, either that or they're just, you know, everybody runs across a person in their life and you go, why are you so miserable? But for the most part nowadays, I think that's changed an awful lot, like you're talking about. Now everybody's for the good of the show, for the good of the performance, especially comics. You need to have everything hit right. You should be prepared. The more prepared you are. I always tell people, you can't be prepared enough to become famous.
Well, be sure to grab the book, Hey Mom.
Hey Mom,
Short Stories from My Mother, but you can read them. You got to check it out. Buy the book. Get it for your mother this weekend for Mother's Day. Louie, always a pleasure. Can't wait to watch the comedy special.
Fun.
And we'll talk to you again soon, my friend. Take care.